morning. Welcome to another trailer build video. Today the goal is to release the Crockett.
The Crockett. Release the Crockett. The Crockett. Release the Crockett. Release the Crockett.
Plastic.
Plastic. Check.
Roll. I mean,
Stain.
Stain.
Check. Tongue and groove.
Tongue and groove.
Check.
3/4 inch brad nails.
3/4 inch brad nails. Check. Okay, so here is the master plan. A lot of chaos with so many different projects all in one project. So today we are going to button up and finalize some things to where we don't have to go back. The first thing we are going to do is cabinet doors and cabinet frames. Today, all cabinet doors are coming down. And cabinet frames are all getting sanded and painted with one coat today. All cabinet doors are getting a coat on one side. Tomorrow they will get a coat on the other side. And that will be a wrap for painting cabinet doors and cabinet frames and sanding. The ceiling is coming down. We're gonna whitewash pine board, the rustic, and hopefully that is dry by tomorrow, and then it hangs tomorrow. So, there's a lot to do. This should be a pretty crazy weekend. A lot of sanding, but I've got, you know, a lot of stuff to do it. Get everything sanded, get everything painted. Tomorrow, the other side gets painted, and then we can move on and hopefully hang ceiling tomorrow. I think I might be a little ambitious with hoping that I can do this in 48 hours because Monday I got a big day at work. But let's get busy.
Bringing the Ark of Chili cold.
Okay, so I got all the doors taken down, and we're gonna start with just caulking the backsides to even this stuff out a little more, of these places that are indented. And then we're going to flip them over and let the caulking dry. And we're gonna do some painting, or maybe even some sanding and some caulk, and some painting on the other side. But we're letting the ceiling dry really good. It's all whitewashed. We're going to work on these cabinet doors, get those going with some caulk and paint. And then while they're drying in the garage, we will come in here and we're gonna start sanding, caulking, and painting all the faces of the cabinets. Maybe even pull these two butcher blocks and get the gray stain going on those. Really just gonna concentrate on some finish paint, caulk, sand, stain, paint, caulk, sand, stain, kind of all in one fell swoop. There's gonna be a lot of dry time needed. So, you know, super excited about all this. It's been really hard to keep the motivation going, especially when progress is like weird and slow. Like it was putting in cabinets and putting in electrical and putting in solar seemed like big changes fast. And now that we're getting to the finished work, I'm noticing that the progress is really slow and it is hard to keep the morale and the energy going. Now, I'm also, not only do I love this cargo trailer build, but I love the videos and I love the YouTube channel. And I think it's like motivating to, you know, make the videos and make progress. So really helps me to pump up. I want to develop my videos better. I want to document the build better, go into more detail better, do the editing better. So please, like, subscribe. It motivates me. I watch a lot of channels and I like and subscribe to make sure that those people that are content creators are feeling acknowledged for what they're doing. And it's really gonna help me motivate me to keep this build going. So I appreciate you watching. Like, subscribe, leave comments, ask me about details. I'm committed to responding. I'm committed to hearing feedback and making changes. Or even if there's something you're struggling on, you know, leave a comment below. I will go into detail on that. That's the point. So I took an old debit card, you know, hotel key style scraper. And used it as a straight edge. And just took some 20-minute Alex's quick dry caulking. And just scraped it along the back of these one more time to fill in low spots or gouges or gaps. I'm gonna let them dry for a while. We've got the whitewashed ceiling boards are drying in the sun. All I did was mix some bright white latex paint with water to thin it out and did like a real quick brush over the tops of all of them so you can still see the knots. I don't want them to be super consistent. I want them to appear a little chaotic. Some are a little whiter than others. I kind of let the paint settle to the bottom. And every so often I would dip kind of deep into the water, getting the thicker whitewash paint. And then on some boards I would literally skim from the top of the whitewash to give it a very thin coat to where I would have kind of a different appearance. And when I hang them, I'm gonna try to hang them in a scattered, chaotic pattern to where there really is some chaos on the ceiling. I don't really like the straight lines. I think there's gonna be a lot of straight lines moving straight down the ceiling. And so I want some chaos up there. I think it's gonna contrast. We're gonna have white ceiling, whitewash ceiling, gray floors, and then all these cabinet faces. First I was gonna do a gray. Now I'm not really liking the gray. I believe I'm gonna go white on white. and the inside of the cabinets, the trim piece, we will stain gray. I think that's the direction I want to go, to just give it a little contrast, do a lot of white. The wallpaper is gray, so we'll do like a dark gray floor, a lighter gray, then the faces of these will be white. There'll be little gray squares on the inside. I think this is too dark. We're gonna try the stain. Hopefully it works, because I spent a long time working on the cabinets. Blue backsplash. This is gonna get stained gray. Most of the walls are pretty, put wallpaper everywhere I can. Everywhere that I can put wallpaper, I will be putting wallpaper. The ceiling whitewash finish. And we'll see how that looks. We're getting pretty close to starting to put these finishing touches together. If I can get the ceiling in this weekend, and get these cabinets faces and painted, faces and cabinet doors painted, I can start doing some wallpaper. I can start doing some wallpaper, but I can't do the wallpaper, can't do the flooring until all the sanding and painting in here is done. Because obviously, once you put the wallpaper up, you want it to be, and the flooring want to be like the last things in, and no paint dripping on them. These need to be stained before I button in these walls, because I can't. Drawers still need to be built. Struggling with exactly how to do that. Bathroom is a completely separate unit, so from the trim piece here to the trim piece here, and the door, can literally be done last. I can finish I can finish the sink and countertop. I can finish the grill and countertop and cabinets. I can finish these cabinets, those cabinets, this cabinet, and start wallpaper back here, because there's really not a lot going on back here. Once we get the wallpaper finished and all painting done, then I will start building the bed, which is going to be a walnut frame with hidden pine. And then, still a lot to do, but we're making some progress. Trying to capture what's happening here, because I'm trying to have a big push this weekend. It seems to be moving along pretty well. So we got a little bit of gray stain on the butcher block. Some of these cabinet doors have their fourth coat, fifth coat. Some of them have their first coat of oil base paint. So hopefully we can stay on schedule. I certainly decided to bite off quite a bit today. Really trying hard get this thing ready to start bolting some stuff down. Kind of holding off on the bathroom, working on these cabinets. So here's my front right entrance door. You will come in. First thing you'll see on your right hand side is the grill top. Then there will be a sliding barn style door that allows you to go into the bathroom shower. Directly in front of the door is going to be a sink countertop with cabinet storage above. To the left of that, refrigerator, microwave. To the left of that, storage. Fold out wall mount sleeper sofa. On the left, identical storage, sleeper sofa. Then in the far back, hippie jack, happy jack, queen sized bed. And in the center will be the two holes for the Texas Hold'em table dinette. Got the furnace right there, battery storage down there, all the Victron components back in there. On top of this countertop will be the grill, probably a range, a hood, a vent, and more storage above that. I'm going to have to put a vent in the shower. Boy, it's dark in there. I'm going to have to put a lot of lights in there. It is dark. Anyhow, let's just keep cracking at it. Let's keep cracking at it. Well, you would think we would have gotten a lot farther, but we whitewashed the ceiling, which was pretty much the goal. The boards are pretty much dry, but I stacked them up to apply pressure on them to keep them from cupping. We did get a coat of paint on the doors. We did get a coat of paint on the faces. And now, as the temperature is dropping, we're trying to do some cleanup. And I think we pretty much did everything that we wanted to do. I would like to do a lot more, but that doesn't seem possible. So get everything cleaned up, hack away at it tomorrow. You know, the goal for tomorrow would be, theoretically, it would be to get the ceiling in. But we got one of the butcher blocks stained back there. It's back there, it's still drying. Couldn't find a better place for it to dry than where it belongs. We got these drying on the floor of the trailer. It's a little chilly, so I don't know how well they're gonna dry, but it sure would be nice if we could get things to dry up in here so that we could hack away at it tomorrow. Pulling this ceiling down is going to be quite dusty and scratchy, but we'll see how it goes. Good morning, sports fans. Happy Sunday. It's a big day. I got a lot I am trying to accomplish. And yesterday I stayed on task and I completed exactly what I set out to. And today I've got even larger ambitions. So, pulling out the ceiling. Why? Because it didn't come out the way I liked. So I'm gonna take this 5mm veneer out and I have to reframe the back portion. I tried to break up the thermal bridging by instead of going crossways, put in that other layer of plywood, or put in a second layer of insulation, and then tried to run supports parallel with the length of the trailer. And is what ended up happening was it created a funny little swell. So it probably could be done if I took it down and recut the size of them, because remember the trailer has a slight bow to the top. So if I was to make these thicker and then the center one even the thickest, that would be fine. But I want to do the pine ceiling, so it's all coming out. Also yesterday my goal was to paint the faces of the cabinets, which was completed, stain countertops, and the what have you. I pretty much met my goal. So today the goal is to paint the backsides of all of these, and then put in this drop ceiling, finish staining that, and have a lot of progress made. Once I get the pine ceiling in, that I whitewashed yesterday. I was gonna stain it. I couldn't find stain that I liked, so I ended up whitewashing. I think it's gonna look great. We have a lot to do. Let's make it happen. Okay. Started taking the panels out before I was gonna show you fellas what was going on. So if you notice in the back here, I did these, studs coming this way. And then when I got to here, I started going right up the middle. So I don't know if I'm gonna undo this one or what, but I do know that this is coming out. So, and the second layer of insulation, and now I really wanted to break up the thermal bridging, but sometimes you have to make a decision based on what you want more. So I really want uniformity and function. I will get a 2x2 in here. I will spray these gaps of foam after I get the second layer of wood up. Get the second layer of wood up. 1.5 by 1, which is what I have back there, giving me more straight lines across. Then I will start in the middle with a plank board, and we've got a thermal break here. I don't know if you can see that, but there is a thermal break under the roof in between this and so I've actually got a little additional protection, and we're gonna utilize that as well as maybe a little bit of thermal tape to break this up. What you got and what you want, baby, I should. Well, it's a 7 o'clock Sunday night, and I am not done. I've made a lot of progress, but definitely not done. And definitely need to get around the air conditioner tonight before the temperature drops and the condensation starts dripping in. Everything is a complete disaster. It's already dark. Temperature is dropping. And there is so much cleanup to do, I can't see straight. So, I think I'm gonna wind it down and start picking up. Maybe put a few more boards in so that I can put these back up. But other than that, 90% accomplished what I wanted to. I was hoping to have not this big of a mess at 7 p.m. But such is cargo trailer life. When you got what you want, maybe I should start over.
Yeah.